The next topic which we are going to start with tools and platforms for the data mining. Data mining uses the different tools and platforms to find the pattern and hidden knowledge or insight values from the data. So there are a wide range of data mining platforms available in the market today. Simple or sophisticated. There are simple end user data mining tools such as Microsoft Excel, and there are more sophisticated tools such as IBM SPSS modeler. So it depends on what kind of data you have and what kind of output you want. So based on that, you can use the simple platform like Microsoft Excel, which is very very simple, or if any complex platform requires, for that IBM SPSS modeler is there. Stand alone or embedded. There are stand alone tools and there are tools embedded in an existing transaction processing or data warehousing or ERP. So these tools are embedded in an existing transaction processing or data warehousing or enterprise resource planning system. So third type of platform, it is a open source or commercial. So they are open source and freely available tools such as Weka, and there are commercial products. So some tools are freely available to use the data mining. Some are commercial, you have to pay and use the platform for the data mining. Fourth type is user interface. So there are text based tools that require some programming skills, and there are graphics user interface based drag and drop formats. So these type of user interface, it can be a text based or it can be drag and drop format tools which will be used for the data mining. Fifth one is data formats. There are tools that work only on priority basis. There are tools that work only on proprietary data formats, and there are those directly accept data from a host of popular data management tools formats. So here data will be put up in a proper format, and it will be directly sent to some company, and it will be managed by the company, and they will be doing the data mining. So what are the next topic? Data mining best practices. So what are the best practices in the data mining we have? So it has effective and successful use of data mining activity requires both business and technology skills. The data mining industry has proposed a cross-industry standard process for the data mining, and it has the 6 essential steps. So let us see what are the 6 essential steps. So you can see the diagram: business understanding, data understanding, data preparation, modeling, evaluation, and deployment. So these are the 6 steps in data mining best practices. So let us have a look one by one. So first is the business understanding. The first and most important step in data mining is asking the right business questions. A question is a good one if answering it would lead to a large payoffs for the organization, and financially and otherwise. So if the first step to understand, we should have understanding of the business. In order to understand the business, first of all, we should ask valid and good questions. If good questions are answered, that will give a good payoffs for the company. In other words, selecting a data mining project is like any other project, in that it should show strong payoffs if the project is successful. If project is successful, it will give a good profit for the organization. There should be strong executive support for the data mining project, which means that the project aligns well with the business strategy. There should be strong executive support for the data mining project, which means that the project aligns well with the business strategy. A properly business strategy should be there for execution of the project, data mining project. A related important step is to be creative and open in proposing imaginative hypotheses for the solution. We should also have imaginative hypothesis where output is not possible, so we can give imaginative hypothesis for the solution. Thinking outside the box is important, both in terms of proposed model as well as in the data sets available and required. So sometimes we should also think out of the box to get the hidden pattern in the data for the data mining. Second best practice is the data understanding. A related important step is to understand the data available for the mining, because different types of data will be there, so we should have expertise to understand the data, then only we can achieve our goal. One needs to be imaginative in scoring for many elements of data through many sources in helping address the hypothesis to solve a problem. Without relevant data, the hypothesis cannot be tested. A proper data should be there to test the hypothesis, then only we can conclude our result. Third is data preparation. The data should be relevant, clean, and high quality. Whatever data we are using for testing hypothesis, it should be relevant, related data, it should be clean and high quality data. It's important to assemble a team that has a mix of technical and business skills who understand the domain and the data. It's important to assemble a team that has a mix of technical and business. So of course, in order to make a good data mining, we should have a technical team as well as business team, because sometimes which is technically strong, that will not be understood by business people, and sometimes which are business oriented, that cannot be understood by the technical person. So both the teams should work together to understand the domain and its data. Data cleaning can take 60-70% of the time in the data mining project. So this is the most time consuming in the data mining project, where data cleaning takes 60-70% of the time. It may be desirable to continue to experiment and add new data elements from external sources of the data that could help improve predictive accuracy. Fourth one, modeling. This is the actual task of running many algorithms using the available data to discover if the hypotheses are supported. This is the actual task of running many algorithms using the available data to discover if the hypotheses are supported. So this is kind of a prototype or final model. So where it is kind of generalizing the model, where so many data